Hi folks, thanks for tuning in again. Got another watercolour demonstration. This time it's a sea, coastal scene. Lots of dramatic colour. I've got to try to get lots of yellows and reds in there and reflect it all in the water below. A few rocks and pebbles scraped out in the foreground. So, before I show you how I did this one, let's look at the colours. So for this one, I used ultramarine, lemon yellow, and just light red. I think it was just the three colours on this one. And then we got the large on Ransanake, used 3/4 inch flat, just for taking out just a little bit of the paint for the waves, and then 2 rigger brushes, number 3, and then a small one. So starting off with clear water, and then I'm going to put the light colours in first, I think. So I'm going to clean that yellow, just a bit of the muck off the top of it, clean the brush. You do the same with the red as well, I think. Clean the brush. And then put the yellow in there. A bit of red. Clean the brush. Let's try a bit of blue. A bit of blue at the top. Clean the brush again, back into a nice light yellow colour. Pop that up there like that. Down into there, back into the red. Strengthen that little bit up there. Clean the brush, back into the blue. This time I'm going to mix the red and the blue together. I'm going to use a clean brush. Lighten some of that. We had a bit of a mess at the bottom area. Too much dark. See what I can do with it. Let's clean that brush again. Some of that yellow in there. Some of that red up to there. Then reflects it down below. Back into the blue, strengthen some of this blue area. Push it down into the red. Right, a bit of tissue work. I'm going to put some land in, try and define where everything is. So I want it quite dark, I'm going to a bit of red, a bit of blue. Quite a dark colour. And then somewhere up there goes a little strip of land. do a little flat brush. Just lighten that just below there. In the brush. And just line it a little bit. Dark colour. Now that's slightly. I'm coming from this side. Get back to this red and blue. Just about a minute to put some rocks or something. I might just well do that actually. And as the paint goes on, the paper starts to dry, it just goes on thicker and thicker. Using a chisel edge, just get these nice dark strips in. I'll just take a little bit more white out actually. This time I'm going to do it with the paintbrush. So it's getting sort of dry and chisely. These just meant to be like little waves and things in the water. Just see what it looks like with a few. Tiny little bit of. These are just little pebbles on the shore. Not keen on them actually, I'm just going to paint straight over these. thicker and smaller like that. I've had a quick dry so I can paint, get a bit more thicker paint on it. Do that horizon a little bit thicker, a little bit stronger. Just need to get it square. A little bit darker. Just being careful to leave that little white bit, it looks like the waves. Keep reloading, I'm just going red and blue, just reloading the brush. Try not to overdo it. So I might have to scrape those little pebbles out again, I think. Give that a quick dry. Need a little yacht somewhere to act as a focal point, so I'm taking a little rigger brush, clean bit of tissue, see what I can do with this brush. I'm quite sure if it will work with this brush. Very flimsy on the end. going to take probably take two or three attempts to get it to get down to the white of the paper. As if the other brush would be too big, I might just try anyway actually. Get to the number three rigger. Dab it with a tissue. Right, let's try and get another one next to it. Try to keep it as small as I can. I just know this twice. It's back into that water the paper. It's a bit rubbish, that is. See, the brush is too thick. No, I'll have to go back to the other one. Pointy edge, pointy top on the sides. I'm just going to put one more in. So these brushes, I've got to get a new one of these. Trying to loosen the paint's triangular shape. Just taking a, just taking an age. Just a combination of the brush. There's just no strength in the ears. I did two layers of this, so I'm having to fight through two layers to get to the white of the paper. So it's just not coming off very well. Some birds in. And I've got the birds right up there. And then finally, somewhere out in the way, I think. Just about to see. Pop me down right in. Stick a mount on that, see what it looks like.
So here's the finished painting, the mount. So if we go and have a closer look. Got some bright colours in the sky, lemon yellow, light red, and a bit of combination of the both. That's reflected right the way down into the water below. Around the lights we've got the blue, ultramarine. A little bit of tissue working to get a little bit of lighter tones and clouds. I then added another layer, another wash, just to strengthen the colours, make it more silhouetted against the lights of the sky. And you can see I've tried to preserve and take out that bit of white there, just make it look like waves in the distance amongst all the dark parts. Lots of pebbles on the beach here in the foreground. You see where the light's reflected in the wet sections. And then you've got stones and pebbles. Bits of light just reflecting off the top of them, look. And then got three little yachts there on the horizon line. Just adds a focal point to the scene.
So that's that for this one.
I hope you enjoy that. Thanks for watching. Keep practicing. Remember, the book's on Amazon. Just search for Stephen Cronin, or you'll follow the link in the description. You see all the materials down there as well. More videos over on Patreon and the paintings for sale on eBay. So keep practicing. Any questions, please ask, and I'll see you again soon.